जय हिंद क्लास, वेलकम लाइव क्लास ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस स्टूडेंट्स। स्टूडेंट्स नाउ चैप्टर ऑल चैप्टर्स कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेजेस प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड। नेक्स्ट माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेल 2016 वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड एंड एज वेल एज फॉर्मूला एंड फंक्शन ऑल्सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड। स्टूडेंट्स नाउ रिगार्डिंग योर हाफ ईयरली एग्जाम वी जस्ट गोइंग टू स्टार्ट रिविजन। सो स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी विल रिवाइज चैप्टर माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेल 2016। सो स्टूडेंट्स नाउ लेट अस सी अबाउट द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेल 2016 अगेन विद द प्रैक्टिकल। सो लेट्स स्टूडेंट्स स्टार्ट विद द पीडीएफ फाइल। सी एवरीवन स्टूडेंट्स। यस नाउ स्टूडेंट्स यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज द चैप्टर 4 Microsoft Excel 2016. As you know, you have already read this chapter and practical also you have done. Again, we will just going to revise what we have to read. Selecting the cells, how we can select the cells, how we can enter numbers as a text or date and time, changing the cell contents using the auto and redo features, how we can insert and delete the cells, columns and rows, copying moving data, how we can do, and using auto fill and flash fill feature. So students, now just going to start how to select the cells. Students, if you want to select the cells, what we can do with the help of this selecting cells, we can copying, moving, inserting and deleting. Here a row or column, how we can click, how we can head row and columns, we can select it, how we can entire worksheet select, how can adjacent row and columns and not adjacent row and column. So students, through the practical I am showing you better. Now Excel we will open. Now this is the blank workbook. Yes students, see students, a row and column, what we click on the row heading and column heading. Students, that we can ask questions. If you want to select the row and column, so what you have to click, so we will click on row heading or as well as the, if you want to column, then column heading. You can see students here, suppose this is the column A, B, C, D, E, F. This is the column 1, 2, 3, 4. These all are rows. The row heading and column. This is the column heading A. The all are selected. B, the all are selected. C, this is the headings. This, when you click on here, then all whatever the column is, this is E. This all O, all column are selected. Huh? You can see up and down. Huh? Same as 1. This is row is selected. 4, 5, 6, these are selected, 10, we have selected, 6, 14. So this way we can select the row and column heading. After that, entire worksheet, there are two options are given, Control plus A and select all button. You can see students, Control plus A, suppose click on A and paste the Control option and A with along with each other. Just together. Okay, what I am doing? Control plus A. Now, what you are seeing on the screen, this all are selected. Again, I am showing you. Just here, we click on this active cell on A1. Okay. Control plus A. Now, we have selected all the entire worksheet. This is the worksheet. Okay. This way we can do. And also, you can see here, 1 and A, that is between this one. If you click on here, also the whole entire worksheet will be selected. See students, see here. Okay, selected now. Again, I'm showing you. See here. Control plus A. This is shortcut is of entire worksheet. Control plus A. Okay, or you can select all here. Okay, this is select all. So with two procedure, we can select the entire worksheet. Clear students? Next one, adjacent row and columns. Select the first row column, then hold down the shift key. Hold down the shift key while you select the last row column. Issuance. Now see everyone. Suppose we have selected here. Now hold down the shift button. Hold down the shift button. I pressing the shift button and now click on here. Suppose 17 and here. See here. Automatic all are selected. You can see again here. If you are doing the without shift, then we can see here. This is without shift. Okay. But suppose H is here, this is H1. And we want to select up till S20. Okay, here. Whole R. So with the help of shift button. See here. Shift hold. I am doing shift now. See here. This all are clear? As the same way we can also do at row options. See here. This one and okay, selected. A at and now we want to S. So what I'm saying, no one selected, but if you hold the shift key and now where, yes, 8, yes, hold down shift key, now see, okay, so this way we can do. Next one is non-adjacent row and column. Non-adjacent means not adjacent, means just like one each other, okay, that means this one is the G2 and G3, this is the adjacent, okay, but G2 and K2, this is non-adjacent. So how we can select it? By the hold down or control key. Can see as well. Suppose we are here, control, see here, selected anywhere, where, see, where we are selecting the M. This is the static portion, this is the, with the hold, with the shift key, control key. This is non-adjacent cell. Again, I'm doing better. D1, now control, see, with the control key, non-adjacent cell. These are, okay, we are holding the control key. This is non-adjacent cell. Clear, issuance? Next one, issuance. Now, we have understood how we can select the cells, row, column heading, entire worksheet, adjacent row and column and non-adjacent row and column. Now we talk about the entering the number as a text. Entering number as a text issuance, CV1, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have entered, what's showing here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? 2, 3, 4, 5. See here. 2, 3, 4, 5. If you start from the 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. See issuance? 0 is not there. Here, see here. 0, 2, 3, 4, 5. What are you getting there? 0? No. So 0 is not accepting. You know, when in anywhere office we were there. So they are 0 accepting. But how we can 0 accepting? See everyone. Before it, when we start from the 0, so we will use the shift plus colon. Apostrophe sign. Shift plus apostrophe sign. On the keyboard you are present. Shift plus, this is the not shift, directly apostrophe sign, then 0 0 1 2 3 4. Look what accepted, 0 accepted here. Again I'm showing you, this is apostrophe sign, 0 2 3 4 5. See here. This is little bit different. They are showing. This is showing as a character. This is showing as a number. This is different of this. When we are putting the comma, this apostrophe sign, so whatever we will write, this is this Excel will take as a character, not as a number. We can write 0, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. Look. Taken. But if simple we will write 0, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, what he will take? Only 1, 2, 3. Clear understood, issuance? So by this way, you can see here, if a number is entering in the format such as 01481 Excel, we'll drop the leading 0 to preserve the leading 0, require in the case of telephone area, codes, roll number, sector, type in apostrophe before the number, apostrophe, there is given, apostrophe, okay, So before like this epistrophe sign 01481, then our number will take as accepting the 0, otherwise not. Okay, typically formulae will treat the entry as a 0 and function will ignore it. Clear students? Now entry and date and time. Before it, a range in the group of contiguous cell which form the shape of a rectangle value, select the range. Okay, I will tell how the work. I have already told you, but again I will revise you. Select the cell and type the date and time. You can separate the date element with a slash sign or hyphen sign. Students, look everyone. Suppose we are deleting this all. Sure, I have understood everyone. 23-09. Suppose today's date is 04-03-08-2020. Okay, what the date is given, we want to change this format. Whatever format is given, right click on here, go on the format cell. Okay, again I'm going. Showing. This is date and time is showing. There are many options are given. You can see here. There are many options are given. Okay, any option you can choose here. Suppose this option we have chosen. Okay. Monday, August 3, 2020. Because we have taken what? 08. A place of we will change here 10, what, Saturday, October 3, 2020. Okay, so with this way we can do students. Again I'm doing some different. Yes, see here, this is different. Whatever the you want to choose here, so with this, with the time you can, you want to choose, so the time. Clear? So by this way we can do this. Clear students? This is the chosen of date and time students. Now after that, changing the cell content, the character and numbers, first of all read to display the entire date in different format. Okay, we have done students. The characters and numbers type in a worksheet can be seen both in a cell as well as on the formula bar. Enter the content and press either the enter key or enter button on the formula bar to accept the entry. When you type in the new data in a cell, the two buttons, cancel button and the enter button present on the left of the formula bar, become active. Cell content can be modified in two ways, replacing cell content or using the edit mode. Replacing cell content, we can edit the cell content directly and replace them with a new entry. Open a new worksheet and type in the data as shown. This is the type. Okay. Select the cell, for example D6. You can see here D6, 56 is given. Issues. Okay, 56 is given. And place of 56, we want to write here 65. So directly we can change, or using the edit mode also we can do. How we will do? You can see everyone. Suppose we are written here serial number, name, and subject we are writing maths and English. Okay, serial number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and name we have written A-A-B-C-D-D-E. Okay, mass number we have taken, suppose 67, 78, 89, 90, and then 56. English marks we have taken 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, 89. Okay. Now here, enter. Students, suppose we are want to change if 56 should be 65. When we click on here, this is ready mode. See here, the cancel button or this is enter button. Okay, or this is the enter button. Clear? So here we can change from here also 56 and 65. Okay, we have done. Also, we can do directly here. 56 is given 65. See here, when you putting here, students, click on here. This is showing on the formula bar. Now active the cross button, cancel button, active the enter button. 65. We can change from here 56. Okay. Now this one is not visible now. Okay. Now you want to change from this side. See, students, this is ready is given. When you click, double click on here. See, this is double click. So what is given here? Edit option. Okay. Now click on here. 65 is showing. 65. Now enter press. Okay. So what we are getting? 65. Clear, students? Next one is given, students. This is replacing the cell contents. Now we have completed, students. Using edit mode also, we have told you how to do this. They are seeing here. Select the D6, double click on the cell. The insertion point will blink with the cell. The same like. See here. When not click on this, is ready option is given. You can see here. Okay. But when you click on here, this is only status bar. Ready option is given. When we click on here, then what's showing here? Edit option. Same option is written here. Insertion point with blink with the cell. Note that the edit mode is indicated on the left side of cell bar. Position the pointer at the desired place and change the contents. Press the enter key, change the will the enter in the current cell. Now that edit mode indicates change to ready mode. We can see also here, students. When we have changed, enter press. Now see here, this is ready option is given. Clear, students? Next one is given using the undo and redo of features. It's very easy. Suppose here, just now we have changed here 56 is given, and now we have changed 65 written. If you want to recall them, you can go from this way. You can see here, this is on title bar, there are given quick access toolbar. This is the quick access toolbar. Click on here. Okay, many options are given. This is a quick access, customized quick access toolbar. Okay, so when you click on here, see here, anything happen? Yes, 56 has come now. Again 65, whatever we are changing, so they are all are showing. Okay, see here, thus, clear na? Now we can just again reschedule them. So this is the control Y, this is the redo option. You can see here. Also you can know with the shortcut keys, control Z and control Y. If last action what you have done, suppose I have written here computer marks. Okay, 778899, that is 55 and 66. Okay, we have written. Now we want to last action whatever we have done, we want to change it. Control Z. See here. Now 66 has gone. Again recall it, control Y. Okay, by this way, control Z and control Y. So the option is given. You can use the shortcut keys control plus Z for undo and control plus Y for redo actions. Some actions cannot be undone, such as clicking any command on this file tab menu. The command or the action cannot be undone. Clear, students? The undo button changes the into cannot undo, and the same as for the redo button. Now inserting cell column and rows. How we can insert the cells, columns and rows? At times while entering the data, you may miss out certain entries. In certain entries, in such situations, you may have to insert some cells, columns or rows in the worksheet to accommodate the new data. Okay, now inserting blank cell. How we can insert the blank cell? Select of there are two ways to insert the blank cells. Select the range of cells where you want to insert the blank cells. You should select the same number of cells as you want to insert the spreadsheet. Students, suppose here there are five options given. You want to insert here five options. Okay. Click on here, right click. Here options is given insert. The automatic insert the cells. Control Z. Control Z we can use. Now the format, the insert option are given. Insert cell, insert sheet rows, insert sheet columns, insert sheet, insert cells. Insert cells, entire row, entire column, enter cells down, enter cells right. Entire cells down. No effect, but if enter insert cells down is given, the right, this is right. What happens is this is the shifted, this shifted here inserted, and this one is whatever given here, this is shifted, these all are suppose you are doing here insert cells, insert shift cell down, shift cell down, shift cell right. So you will get here in blank cell. Okay, see here, this is also shifted. Same here, insert cells, insert cells right. See here, so many options there is given. Insert cells right. Same for this one. Everyone, okay. Now we all are shifted. We have got this blank cell. Between the English and computer, we want to add a columns. This is for Hindi. Go here, select it, format. Sorry, not format. Insert. Insert what? Insert sheet columns. See here. Inserted now. Okay. You can write here Hindi. 6677889910. Okay. This way you can do. Now if you want to change insert the row here, go on the insert options. Now insert sheet rows. See here, this is the 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now here inserted the numbers 77 45 56, now here 88, and then is the 99. Okay, this way. So this is the options of how to insert the row, columns and blank cell. Okay, now deleting the cells, columns and row, how we can delete the row, column and cells. See students, suppose here delete options, delete cells. Okay, shift cells left, shift cells up, entire row, entire column. See what happens. Shift cells up. See here, it's shifted. Okay, now shift cell left. See here, what happened? Shifted. All the things are shifted on the left side. Here, delete option. Now, cells left. See students, shifted. Here, delete option. Shifted now. Sorry, not delete option. Here is here. Okay, this way here we have see it option. So with this way we can if you want to arrange it with the help of Control Z undo option, we can do from this side or Control Z option. See students, all things are, we have got it. Okay, now next, how we can delete the, suppose this one to, we want to delete it. Okay, date option, date set column, see, deleted. You can recall it, control Z. Okay, if column, suppose this one, delete option, delete set rows, deleted. If you want to recall it, control Z. Okay, students, so now we have understood this one. Next one is given, changing the row height and column width. Students, we have asked this question, ki by default, what is the height of the column and width? The column height is given 8.4, column width is given 8.43 and row height is given 15 points. CV1, if we talk about this format, row height. See, this is 15, this is row height by default. Students, this is active cell on the B4, because then value is written, so we are showing here. By default, it's a blank cell, what is the height, and if you talk about row height is given 15, okay? And then we talk about the column width, 8.43, this one is. This is the height, this is the width, 8.43. Suppose if you want to increase this row height, so 15 is given, you can change 20 you have written. See here, now this is increases. Same as column width, 8.43 is given, suppose you have written 10. This is also increases. Now you can see by default, not by default, what you have written. Column width, 10. We have done, and the row height 20. Clear, students? So we can change. Clear, students? So this is row height option, column. There is given. Select the row, click the drop down arrow of the format button in cells group on the home tab. Okay, whatever we have done. Here, format button, row height, and column width. Format button in the cells group on the home tab. CV1, this is the cells button, and format, delete, and insert. Insert for inserting, okay, delete for deleting, and format for, we can format it. Okay, students, to change the column width, we have done now this one, copying and moving data. Students, first of all, you want to tell that what are the difference between copying and moving data. Copy refers to duplicate data, and moving refers to changing the position of the data. Means, if you will copy the data from one place to another, so both place we will get data. But moving, we will, if you are changing the place, to only one place we will get where we have kept. Okay, CV1. Suppose this data we want to from clipboard. Here the options are given. The cells or range that you want to copy. Copy button on the clipboard group. This is clipboard group. You can see, students. This is clipboard group. Okay. Suppose this one is we have copied. Okay. Copy. Here want to paste it. Paste. See, students, in both place we are getting this number. This is the means of copy. Okay, control Z option. If you want to only cut it, cut. Okay, now click on here, paste. See, students, what difference here? Only one place we are getting the this number. So this is the meaning of the copy and paste. Cut and copy. Okay, again I'm repeating, students. First of all, we done copy. Okay, and here paste. Okay, so both place we are getting, this means is the copy the data. Oky, this means a copy data. But if you have cut it, you have cut it, and now here place paste here, so it means the moving the data, only one place you will get where you have kept. Clear, students? So by this way, we can understand the cut and copy paste option. Copy and paste option, and next one is given. They not given the cut and paste option, but we have told you students. Okay. Just moving data is given. That means the same as the thing. Moving tool. Notice that the pointer changes from a white cross symbol to point symbol. There is given Control X, Control C, and Control V. If drag and drop method, see here, drag and drop method. See here, this is the drag and drop method. This is also moving the file, moving the data. See here, this one is showing this symbol, and click on here. See here, this is moving. Okay, so by this way also we can do students. Sorry students. Next one is given using the autofill and flash fill feature. See, autofill features is the easiest method to fill data automatically in the worksheet cell. Suppose B1 January, mouse pointer changes into black, plus cross symbol, hold down the left mouse button and drag the fill handles. February to May appear in the cells B2 May 5. Students, what we want to tell you, suppose we have written here January. Okay, January we have written. Now you can see students, this is the this like a symbol, but when you come here, see, now Feb showing students, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. See here, this is the role of the which one is autofill. Okay, autofill feature. Okay, autofill feature is to reduce our work. If you want to write the Mondays, Sunday, Monday, okay, so also this one. After Sunday, what will come? Monday, see here. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Okay, clear students? This is the autofill feature. Next one is students, the flash fill. Name an initial point. Make two columns, names and initial, in the Excel sheet. Suppose we are making. Here given name and initial. Name. Initial. What written name here? Suppose Ravi Kumar Suresh Singh. Okay. This whole point is given Ravi Kumar. Suresh Singh. Next one is given Rakesh Bhatt, Shruti Sharma. Rakesh Bhatt. Rakesh Bhatt, Suresh Sharma. Next one is given Vijay Negi. Vijay Negi. Okay students. Next one is given. Initial column should have combination of first character of first name, and suppose this is Ravi Kumar, so RK should be there. First letter of this one and second letter of this one. Type RK in the initials, columns and press enter key. Click on the fill drop down arrow present on the home tab, editing group, and select the fill options. You can also use this control, so shortcut key control plus E. Okay students, see everyone. We now doing, we have written first is R K. We have written next column where editing option. They have you can see students, in this place we are getting fill drop down arrow present, then home tab in editing group. Editing group, this one editing group, fill, the flash fill. See here, RK for Ravi, Suresh Singh SS, Rakesh Bhatt RB, Suyash Sharma SS, Vijay Nagi the PL. Okay, so we had written we just control plus C. See here, this is using control plus C. Students, again I am showing you RK, we have written students RK. Okay, now go on the home tab, editing option, fill option and flash fill. See each and every one we have got the name, our name first letter and the second name of first letter. Okay, next one, control plus C also, control plus E. Wait, you will take also this one, control plus E. Okay, so this way you can do students. Now students, now students, whole thing we have covered up. Students, you can see here today approx you all things of this chapter we have completed. Sorry students, this is the next chapter. Yes, this chapter beta. Okay, so flash fill, auto fill and other thing we have discussed students. Now recap, you know it very well, fill in the blanks you have written, true false, each and everything you have written students. Beta, now you have to learn beta, it's time to learn. Now we have covered up your this chapter with the practical, with the theory. Clear students? Okay students, we have covered up your this chapter Microsoft Excel 2016. Students, I request to everyone, students, learn it very carefully. Computer language we have already done in UMAP and the first chapter, also previous class, and this chapter also we have covered up, and hope everyone learn also. Next class we will revise formula and function students. Clear students? So till that you have to learn all the things of this three chapters students. Clear? Because very soon your half yearly exam going to start students. So everyone ready for this one? Okay, so students, now I'm leaving class. Thank you students. Jai Hind.